Yo, what up guys? It is the Ultimate Frozen Fan back here with another unboxing video, and oh boy, do we have a big one today. It's the Sora Nendoroid from Kingdom Hearts by the Good Smile Company, number 965. I'm not sure if that means that's how many they've produced or exactly what that means, but that's what it is. So, picked this up at Best Buy of all places. It was in the video game section. I couldn't believe they have it, because usually you can't find these really nice, like, Nendoroid or Figma figures. I mean, you can find a few for video games, but not much else. Not for, like, anime or anything else like that. So, super excited to get it. Kind of sometimes wonder why these are so expensive. I guess it's because they're imported, but this cost $50, and it's a bit steep, but I didn't care. You know, I really wanted it, and it's got a lot of nice stuff and everything, so it's worth the price. I just wonder why it's so expensive when our U.S. Action figures are usually no more than $20, but whatever, it is what it is. So, on the front, you can see we have a nice little thing of Sora, and then there's Sora in there with all his accessories. On the side, we've got Sleeping Sora, Sora with the Paupu Fruit, and we've got Sora with the Pumpkin Head Keyblade. So glad they included that, because that is one of my favorite Keyblades from the Nightmare Before Christmas world. More Sleeping Sora, Sora holding his Keyblade, similar to the way he does in on Kingdom Hearts 1's instruction manual and stuff like that. And then, we've got Sora with the pumpkin head in hand, and then we've got Sora locking the keyhole. And then on the bottom, we've got Sora again with the pumpkin head, and then at the top, same Sora. So, so there's a lot of cool things that you can do with this thing, so looking forward to getting in all kinds of cool poses and everything. So without further ado, let's get to it and crack this thing open. Some more tape on this thing? Nope, okay, just clean it up. Alright, and here we go. You can see all the Sora's accessories. He comes with multiple faces, obviously, to get multiple facial expressions. Go ahead and take this plastic off. It's snapped in there with the lid. There we go. And then there's all the pieces, so give me a minute to get all these things out of the plastic, and then we'll take a quick look at the accessories, and then we'll take a quick look at Sora. Also, it's very important that you read your instructions so that you know how to change the pieces and everything on this thing without breaking it or anything, which is a lesson that I learned with my Kingdom Hearts 3 Bring Arts figures of Toy Story, Sora, Donald, and Goofy. Don't worry, they didn't break, it's just I had a hard time getting the accessories in their hands, and I almost could have broken their hands, but I saw the instructions that it said that you have to remove part of the weapon first, like Donald's staff and Sora's Keyblade, to get them in there. You don't just have to push them in there. So, yeah, always be sure to read your instructions. I'm going to take a look at these before I show off the accessories. So I'll be back. Alright, so here's Sora out of the packaging and all of his beautiful animatistic glory. And he's pretty small, but he's got a big head, so really, really cute. These Nendoroid things are really cute, so I like them. I like the way they look and everything. So let's take a closer look at Sora's accessories, and then we'll get a better look at Sora when to start posing him and whatnot. So you have two interchangeable faces. You have an angry face, and you have the sleeping face. It's so weird seeing these Nendoroids with no hair. They look like baby heads, kind of. It's kind of freaky. Then you've got the Kingdom Key, looking really nice. The keychain is not doesn't just flop on there. It's stuck in the position that it's in. So here's the pumpkin head. Jack Skellington head right there, looking super cool. The pumpkin keychain, which also doesn't flop around, it's stuck in that position. Here's the keyhole for Here's the keyhole for Sora to lock. Here's a light beam that goes in, comes from the keyhole, so like kind of like this. And here's the beam of light that shoots from the keyblade into the keyhole. You get an extra neck joint. They always put in an extra neck joint. You get two pairs of Keyblade holding hands, or yeah, I think those are two pairs. Yeah, it looks like so. Wonder if you can get this to hold the Keyblade with both hands or not. Probably not. And then last but not least, you get a Nendoroid figure stand for this, so you can port this into any of these pegs here and get Sora in some pretty dynamic poses. And only I could figure out which way these things go in. There we go, so something like that. So there's so many dots here that you can change wherever you want to put these depending on how far or how close you need the figure from the stand. So pretty cool. So so now let's go over articulation for Sora. Doesn't look like he can really move his head up. I mean, maybe he can. It doesn't look like it, but can move his arm outward. He can't. Doesn't look like he can do a 360. No, he kind of can. Just the hair kind of gets in the way, and he's got looks like single jointed elbows. Does not have any wrist articulation. No ab crunch or anything like that. But his legs don't move too forward out, but he can kick forward and kick back a little bit. Bends at the knees a little bit. His ankles move up and down. Doesn't have toe articulation, but looks like he does have a little bit of ankle pivot, but not too much. So, yeah. So not too much on the articulation, but considering, you know, like his big head and small limbs and everything, it's actually not too bad for what they managed to do with him. So, all right, let's start getting this guy in some cool poses. So, I'll be back. All right, so there's pose number one of Sora holding his key... Ah, dang it. Okay, so there's Sora holding his Keyblade. Not perfect, and of course the Keyblade doesn't really stay upright. You kind of clip the keychain kind of onto Sora's hand in order to get it to stay good, but yeah, it works better with the stand. So all right, next. So here's Sora sleeping on the beach, probably dreaming about Dive to the Heart and getting eaten by the dark side and everything. So yeah, here's Sora looking down at the Paupu fruit that he's holding, thinking about sharing it with Kairi. Sora ready for action with the pumpkin head or the Kingdom Key. Sora locking the keyhole with Pumpkinhead. Locking the actual keyhole with the Kingdom Key. And finally, we've got Sora in his classic crouching Keyblade holding in both hands pose. You all know the one I'm talking about. Yeah. So, overall, guys, this is a good figure. I really, really like it. A lot of cool poses, a lot of options and stuff to do with it. I do, however, think that $50 is kind of a steep price point for this thing. I mean, it, especially considering this stand right here keeps popping off, his limbs and stuff all keep popping off. The keychain of the Kingdom Key easily pops off and everything, so... have to keep putting it in, so it's a bit of an annoyance and more of a gripe for me, but, I mean, you get a good amount of accessories and stuff like that, but I still think $50 is really steep for this thing. $20 or even $30 would have been a bit better, but, hey, it is what it is. What are you gonna do? So, overall, I give this figure a 4 out of 5. It's great. I love it. A lot of cool options and accessories. Just a couple of gripes of that things keep popping out. The limbs, the hands, the stands, and everything. Nothing's yet to break. It just pops out, but it goes right back in. But yeah, so... So I would recommend this to Kingdom Hearts fans of the older generation, because this is definitely not for kids. I mean, it's more for adult collectors. I mean, it even says right here. Hang on. If I can get that to focus. Ages 15 and up. So, Yeah, definitely not for younger kids to play with, because this thing is kind of delicate and will break, but I love it. I still like it and everything. So, if you enjoyed this video, be sure to drop a like. Helps out the channel. Let me know in the comments what you think of this figure, if you plan on getting it or if you're not going to get it. Share this video with your friends, subscribe, and hit that notification bell so you don't miss out on any videos. And until next time, guys, this is the Ultimate Frozen Fan signing off. Peace.